injuries. This time it's just a drill, but it's designed to keep all commuters safe.
And we want to go out to the eye openers. Andrew Antonio, who's live for us in East Boston, with more on what first responders really learned from this exercise overnight. Antoinette.
And Bianca and Erica, those first responders, they converged on the Sumner Tunnel overnight to make sure everyone knows what to do if and when this really happens. They say the key to saving lives is working together.
We're always looking to improve, and this is how we improve.
This being an emergency drill, a car crash simulation in the Sumner Tunnel. X marks the spot, the car involved in the crash. Smoke clouding the air, making it hard for first responders to see. It's a scene that played out in the tunnel years ago and has potential to happen again, with so many tunnels connecting Boston's roads. The goal of this drill overnight, getting to people who are trapped inside.
Working as a team, getting Boston Fire to where they need to be to do what they need to do.
As hard as it is to get into the one-way tunnel filled with smoke and traffic backing up, another wrench was thrown into the situation.
We didn't have communications, which is a huge issue for us.
The lesson learned here, teamwork makes all the difference.
We were able to get inside the tunnel, work with the state police, work with EMS, and also to exercise some things that, thank God, we don't normally happen on a regular basis.
And overall, this emergency drill proved to be a success. The Sumner Tunnel was closed overnight for about 5 hours, but once again, it is back open this morning. We're live in East Boston. Antoinette Antonio, WCVB, News Center 5.